Hello everyone, I am Shweta and welcome to my channel Analytics by Shweta. In today's video, we will learn how to create a horizontal average line in Excel. We had learned how to create a vertical average line in our previous video. If you want to have a look at that video, please refer to the link in the description box. Now, if you see in this visual, we have the highest for 2023, which is represented in yellow color. Wherever the highers is greater than the average highers, those highers are represented in a blue bar. Plus, we have an average line represented here along with the average number. As you increase or decrease the values over here, the average line would change dynamically and update itself. So let's go ahead and create this chart. We need to have two helper columns, which says highers greater than average, and then we have the average. So let's first calculate the average. The average is this. We lock the cells and we approve it. We remove the decimals and we drag the formula down. Next is, if this is greater than or equal to the average highers, then return me the highers value, else return me any, and we close this. If you see here, wherever the highers is greater than the average, we get the highers value, and for the rest we get it as any. Let's create our chart. Select these two and select a clustered bar chart. Select any one of the series and overlap it to 100%. Reduce the gap width so that the bars are a little bit thicker. Let us delete the grid lines. Next, you select your chart. You go to select data and do add and add the average. And let us add the average series onto our report. If you see in our chart, the average is being added, but it is added as a bar chart. We do not want it as a bar chart. We want it as a line chart. So you select the average series, go to change chart type, and here select a line. Now if you see, we get a line over here. We need to change the format of this line. So we go to the format data series. We say give it in black color and the dash type. So now we have an average line present here in a dashed format. Next is, we require the data labels to be entered here. So for that, we add data label and we say this plus 10. We add 10 to it so that it is not cluttered along with the series. There is some gap available. So we select the series, we say chart design, we say select data, then we go to add. The series name is the data label and the series value is this 286. And we say OK. Now if you see, we can't see it in the chart because it is present on top of our series. So let's go here and select the data label. If you see, a data label is selected over here. We go here and then add data labels. So you see a data labels is added. We were not able to select the series because it was overlapping these bars. So if you have an issue like this, just select your series and then from here we can select data label and go to a particular series. Now I have already added the data label which is here. So let me format this data label and put it as above. So my data label comes above. But 286 is not the value which I want to be represented. I want the value 276 to be represented. So I select the data label and I say format data labels. Then I say value from cells and then I select 276 and I say OK. Now from here I uncheck the value, and if you see here, my data label is showing the average line. The next is to change the color of the series. So my highest series has to be in a yellow color and my highest greater than average has to be in a blue color. So we have done that. We can just adjust the data label accordingly. Next is to adjust the legends. So we can just remove this data labels and this shows the average line. So as you enter the values, for example, if you enter 800 here, your average automatically changes. If you have 600, you have 1000. So it's a dynamic way. You can further go ahead and add data labels to all these series and get your value for each of these months' individual highs. But it would be better if you format these data labels and put it in inside base. Otherwise, it will get cluttered along with your data labels for the average. So I have put the data labels as on inside base so that it comes at the bottom of the bar chart. So this is how you create an average horizontal line in Excel. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell for more updates. Thank you for your time and have a nice day.